This is the night of salvation, the eve of our Lord's resurrection. We gather around a fire, the word, the water, the bread, and the wine, proclaiming through story and song that ours is a God who continually brings life out of death. I am Nicodemus, who came to the Lord in the darkness, and in that darkness, in his death, I helped prepare his body with Joseph. And now we wait, and know this cannot be the end of the story, what we saw last night. For on this night, we experience again the heart of God's baptismal promise, the center of our faith. We are claimed and cleansed, renewed in the death and resurrection of the Anointed One. I know he is the Anointed One, and tomorrow will bring forth light like we've never saw before. We gather with all the saints of every time and place to celebrate this good news. Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Eternal giver of life and light, this holy night shines with the radiance of the risen Christ. Renew your church with the Holy Spirit given in holy baptism, that we may worship you sincerely, genuinely, with an authentic spirit, in truth, and may shine as hope for this world of struggles. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us, the weight of every curse upon him. Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broken. The ground began to shake, the stone was rolled away. His perfect love could not overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated. Forever he is glorified. Forever he is lifted high.
Forever he is glorified.
hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. The Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. We sing hallelujah. The Lamb has overcome. We sing hallelujah.
This night we also gather around God's Word, and it might take you to stories from Genesis to Revelation. You may want to hear again and be renewed in the creation story, Genesis chapter 1 and 2, for God is the only one who creates. And then respond in Psalm 136 that God's mercy endures forever. In the midst of all the changes, God's love and mercy endures forever. Then we may be taken to the 7th and 8th chapters of Genesis and be washed anew by the flood waters and the promise of God's eternal covenant. And then Psalm 46 might remind us that the Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our stronghold. Perhaps you would like to hear the story again of Abraham and Sarah in the 22nd chapter of Genesis, how they were tested and how we are tested. And in Psalm 16, that God shows us the path of life. Perhaps you want to be renewed in the story of Exodus in the 14th and 15th chapters, where God delivers his people from slavery, from captivity, from that which binds us up and seeks to silence us. There are many stories. Isaiah chapter 12 blesses us with a joy that will draw water from the wells of salvation. The wisdom of God is celebrated in Proverbs 8 and 9. But I am drawn to Ezekiel chapter 36, the great prophet, especially verses 24 through 28, where God gives us a new heart and a new spirit. This is what I need this night, dear Lord, in the midst of the darkness, in the midst of my grieving. So I hear Ezekiel chapter 36, starting with verse 24. I will take you from the nations and gather you, says our God, from all the countries, and bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleanliness, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. Take away, Lord, all of that which tries to get our attention, tries to claim our time and our resources, these idols that mislead us. Draw us to you, Lord. Verse 26, a new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you. I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you the heart of flesh. I came to you that night, not knowing fully what to expect, and you blessed me with a new heart. You gave me the will to believe that you are more than just a man. You are the anointed one, the Messiah, who brings salvation life. I'm waiting. My flesh is weak, and the darkness is real. But you give me a new heart this day, and your Holy Spirit fills me with certainty. Verse 27, I will put my spirit within you, and you have, Lord, and I thank you. I will make you follow my statutes and be careful to observe my ordinances. I, a teacher of the law, renewed, recalibrated my understanding so that I may fulfill my place in your kingdom by following your rules, by following your teachings, by being drawn to your word in a new way. And then you shall live in the land that I give to your ancestors. You shall be my people. I will be your God. Dear God, this night, make me your people, for you certainly are my God. Amen.
In the darkness, we were waiting without hope, without light, till from heaven you came running. There was mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of the church, you lit the new fire of resurrection in the darkness of the tomb. Rekindle faith in our hearts that your church, your people, might arise in the promise of new life, the new heart, and new hope. God of creation, the earth itself is waiting for healing and redemption. Protect the coastlines, the reefs, the forests, the prairies, the atmosphere from which we draw the breath of life. God of all people, your word is global in all times, in all places, in all generations. But too often, the injustice of the cross echoes in our human behaviors and systems. Break these cycles of vengeance and violence between peoples and nations. Bring liberation to every place of captivity, merciful God. God of compassion, you know every heart that aches with loss and every mind that knows the weight of the tomb. Keep vigil with those who live with mental illness. Comfort the grieving and strengthen all who are close to death. God of resurrection, the empty tomb proclaims that death itself is swallowed up as we remember those whose lives on earth have ended. Comfort us with the promise of resurrection. Remember us in your kingdom, dear Lord, teaching us to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The God of resurrection and power, Christ of unending joy, the Spirit of Easter hope, bless you now and bless you always. Good night.